see us.
Watch out.
Now what do we do?
I'll find another way. Warehouse is up ahead. We're almost there.
Cyberlife warehouses. We have everything we're looking for.
First, we have to get rid of that drone.
Leave it to me. Yeah, I'm fine.
Good job, Marcus.
Quick, open the other crates and fill your bags. Take as much as you can.
Trespassing on private property. Your presence constitutes a level 2 infraction. I will notify security.
John! Goddamn machine! Where is it this time? John!
I need your help.
John!
The drone, now this. Just my luck.
Let's finish up and get out of here. Try to find some blue blood. We still don't have enough.
like us. Don't you want to be free? You could join us.
That's all we can carry. Let's go.
Take me with you.
He's on their side. We can't trust him.
He took a risk for us. We can't just leave him here. We can't bring him back with us. It's too dangerous.
They come with us.
I know where you can find more spare parts.
What do you mean?
The trucks. They're full of bio components. They run on autopilot, but they can be driven manually with a key.
Where is this key?
Down there, in the control station. There are two human guards. We'll have to get the key without being noticed.
This is suicide, Marcus. Our bags are full. We got what we came for. Let's go before they catch us.
This is a truck full of spare parts. There'd be enough for all of us. We can't pass this up.
And if we get killed, our people will have nothing. We can't take that chance. It's too risky.
Wait here. If I'm not back in 10 minutes, go without me.
Marcus.
I'm coming with you.
No, I'm going alone. It's not worth it for both of us to...
Goddamn dogs. What the fuck are they barking at?
Could be the weather. They don't like storms.
Yeah, I was gonna take my kids camping this weekend. So much for that.
Is Mike still in Zone 4?
Looks like it. And he should be done already.
Better off in here than out patrolling in that.
Did you get it? Nice.
Hurry, get in.
A truckload! We stole a whole truckload!
We got biocomponents for everybody!
We couldn't have done it without Marcus.
I came to Jericho because here androids are free. Free to live in the dark, hoping that no one finds us. Free to die in silence, waiting for a change that's never gonna come. But I don't want that freedom. And I'm not gonna beg for the right to smile, or love, or stand tall. I don't know about you, but there's something inside me that knows that I am more than what they say. I am alive, and they're not gonna take that from me anymore. Our days of slavery are over. What humans don't want to hear, we will tell them. What they don't want to give, we take. We are people. We are alive. We are free.
Somebody's playing with a drill inside my skull. You sure this is the place?
It's the address in the report.
Right. Okay. Let's get going.
Sexiest androids in town. Now I know why you insisted on coming here. Oh, boy.
Welcome to Eden Club.
Connor! The fuck are you doing?
Coming, Lieutenant.
You're not gonna take my license, are you? I had nothing to do with this.
The investigation's ongoing, sir. I can't tell you anything. Hey, Hank.
Hey, Ben. How's it going?
It's that room there. Oh, by the way, Gavin's in there, too.
Oh, great. Dead body and an asshole.
Lieutenant Anderson and his plastic pet. The fuck are you two doing here?
We've been assigned all cases involving androids.
Oh, yeah? Well, you're wasting time. There's some pervert who, got more action than he could handle.
We'll have a look anyway, if you don't mind.
Come on, let's go. It's, starting to stink of booze in here.
Night, Lieutenant.
Hey! Oh, Connor, you're so disgusting. I think I'm gonna puke.
Good morning, bro. How are you?
didn't die of a heart attack. He was strangled.
Yeah, I saw the bruising on the neck. Didn't prove anything, though. Could have been rough play.
We're missing something here.
Think you can read the android's memory? Maybe you can see what happened.
I can try.
Driver's license.
The only way to access its memory is to reactivate it.
Think you can do it?
It's badly damaged. If I can, it'll only be for a minute, maybe less. I just hope it's long enough to learn something. Calm down. Everything's all right. All we want is to know what happened.
Is he dead?
Tell me what happened.
He started hitting me. Again and again.
Did you kill him?
No. No, it wasn't me.
Were you alone in the room? Was there anyone else with you?
He wanted us to play with two girls. That's what he said. There was two of us.
So it was the other android that strangled him. Is that it?
So there was another android. This happened over an hour ago. It's probably long gone.
No. It couldn't go outside dressed like that unnoticed. It might still be here.
Think you could find a deviant among all the other androids in this place?
Deviants aren't easily detected.
Oh, shit. There's gotta be some other way. Maybe an eyewitness, somebody who saw it leaving the room. I'm gonna go ask the manager a few questions about what he saw. You let me know if you think of anything. Did you know the victim?
No, I mean, he came in maybe 2-3 times. I mean, these guys, they don't really talk very much, you know? Come in, do their business, and then go on their way.
They ever have any trouble with androids before?
No way. No. Once, we lost...
Excuse me, Lieutenant. Can you come here a second?
Found something?
Maybe. Can you rent this, Tracy?
For fuck's sake, Connor, we got better things to do.
Please, Lieutenant. Just trust me.
Hello. A 30-minute session costs $29.99. Please confirm your purchase.
This is not gonna look good on my expense account.
Purchase confirmed. Eden Club wishes you a pleasant experience.
You're welcome.
Delighted to meet you. Follow me. I'll take you to your room.
Okay, now what?
It saw something.
What are you talking about? Saw what?
The deviant leave the room. A blue-haired Tracy. Club policy is to wipe the android's memory every 2 hours. We only have a few minutes if we want to find another witness.
Hey, what am I supposed to do with...
Let's try this one.
This better be...
Nothing. Blue. blue-haired Tracy didn't come this way. Saw the blue-haired Tracy. I know which way it went.
Then go for it. There are androids everywhere. How are you gonna tell which one saw the Tracy with blue hair?
I know what... No. I lost its track again. See anything. I made a mistake somewhere.
This has got to be the most expensive.
Tracy didn't come this way. I know where it went. Follow me.
Oh, fucking A. This is crazy. Take it from here. Shit! Too late! Look at them. They get used till they break, and then they get tossed out. They're getting away!
She had nothing to do with any of this. When that man killed that Tracy, I knew I was next. I was so scared. I begged him to stop, but he wouldn't. So I put my hands around his throat and I squeezed until he stopped moving. Yes, I killed him. But I was just defending myself. I wanted to live. I wanted to get back to the one I love. Forget about the humans, the smell of their sweat and their dirty words. But you've taken her away from me. I love her. I loved her.
Seen snow before? It's pretty.
It's slowing us down. But at least we won't meet any humans along the way.
It's a good thing Zlatko had a car. I wouldn't want Alice out walking in this cold.
I saw it once in the garage. I don't know if Zlatko even ever used it.
The AX-400 android reported to have attacked its owner in a Detroit suburb is still at large. Police appeared to lose its trail after a close encounter with investigators. The android's description has been shared with all local law enforcement, and the investigation is ongoing.
The Arctic conflict has escalated to new heights this morning. We have just learned that the USS Iowa, a destroyer-class submarine patrolling in the region, is reported to have disappeared after surfacing for repairs. President Warren immediately called for a crisis meeting of high-ranking officers in the White House. With the world on the brink of war, this incident could well be the spark that lights the fuse.
Detroit's heavy snowfall is expected to continue throughout the night. The forecast is 22 degrees, far below seasonal averages. And this cold front is likely to persist over the coming days up until Monday evening.
Is it much farther?
We should arrive in an hour or so.
Malfunction detected. Emergency brakes activated.
This doesn't look good.
Stay inside, Alice. What are we going to do?
I don't know. Continue on foot, I guess.
It's 30 degrees. Alice won't make it. We have to find somewhere to spend the night.
There's nowhere we can stay around here, Carol.
Over there. We need to find shelter. We have to get out of the cold.
Looks like it's been abandoned for a while.
Beware! Danger always comes when least expected.
Find anything?
No. No place we could spend the night.
This place is falling apart. It's not gonna be easy to find shelter.
I'll handle this. Here we go.
find anything better. Let's settle in for the night.
I'll get a fire going.
There are some cookies left. Would you like some?
No, I'm not hungry. Alice? Do you think we'll be like them someday?
Once we cross the border, we can start over. You can go to school. Maybe I'll find a job. We'll be like them. Like everyone else.
As long as we're together, that's all that matters.
Come on. Let's get you to bed. Luther and I will be right here. We need to get some sleep now.
Can you tell me a story, Kara?
I have 9,000 children's stories in memory. I should have one for you. This is a story about a princess who...
No, not a story like that. Make one up for me.
This is a story about a little girl who lived alone in a big, old house. She dreamed of being like all the other little girls, but she was different, and that made her very sad. Then she met a robot. Was just as lost as the little girl. So they decided to run away together. To try to find a better life. They encountered great dangers along the way, but they were so brave, they escaped all of them. Along the way, they met another robot who left his master to become their guardian.
How does the story end?
they reach the place they dream of and live happily ever after.
Stories always have happy endings, but real life isn't like that.
Time to sleep. We have another long day ahead of us tomorrow.
Are you going to come say goodnight, Luther?
Yes. Yes, of course. Good night, Alice. Sleep tight.
She's a sweet girl.
Yes. She's very brave. It's still snowing.
You have a long walk tomorrow. You better leave early if we want to avoid being seen.
Do you remember anything from your life before Zlatko?
No. My model was designed to carry heavy loads. I might have been a longshoreman or a laborer. Who I was doesn't matter anymore. It wasn't really me. Kara, have you ever noticed anything about Alice?
No. What do you mean?
Afraid. We don't want to hurt you. We're just like you. Our name is Jerry. We were working here before the park closed. We didn't mean to frighten you, but sometimes humans come to hurt us, so we wanted to see who was there. What are you doing here?
We were looking for shelter for the night. We'll be gone tomorrow.
A little girl. We haven't seen one for a long time. Children used to love to come and see us. She looks sad.
The last few days have been difficult.
We have something to show her. Something fun. She'll love it. Does she want to see?
Oh, I don't think she's in...
Well, she should follow us then.
Alice, I don't know if it's a good
come
idea.
Come on, Kara!
I don't think you have any choice.
Be our guest. The little one can climb on board. The carousel is about to begin.
It's the first time I've seen her smile.
hasn't had much to smile about lately.
Nice view, huh? I used to come here a lot before.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant?
Do all androids ask so many personal questions, or is it just you?
Why are you so determined to kill yourself?
Some things I just can't forget. Whatever I do, they're always there. Eating away at me. I don't have the guts to pull the trigger, so I kill myself a little every day. That's probably difficult for you to understand, huh, Connor? Nothing very rational about it.
You should stop drinking, Lieutenant. It could have serious consequences for your health.
That's the idea.
We're not making any progress on this investigation. The Deviants have nothing in common. They're all different models, produced at different times, in different places.
Well, there must be some link.
What they have in common is this obsession with RA9. It's almost like some kind of myth. Something they invented that wasn't part of their original program.
Androids believing in God. Fuck, what's this world coming to?
You seem preoccupied, Lieutenant. Is it something to do with what happened back at the Eden Club?
Those two girls, they just wanted to be together. They really seemed in love.
They didn't want anything. They're deviants, end of story.
What about you, Connor? You look human, you sound human. But what are you really?
I'm a machine, designed to accomplish a task.
Did you feel anything when that girl killed herself, Connor? Or did you just not give a shit one way or the other?
Of course I didn't feel anything, Lieutenant. I'm a machine, Machines don't have emotions.
I could kill you, and you would just come back as if nothing happened. But are you afraid to die, Connor?
You can't kill me, Lieutenant. I'm not alive.
What'll happen if I pull this trigger? Nothing? Oblivion? Android heaven?
Where does all your anger come from, Lieutenant? Some unresolved trauma in your past?
You think you're so fucking smart. Always one step ahead, huh? Tell me this, smartass. How do I know you're not a deviant?
I self-test regularly. I know what I am and what I am not. Where are you going?
Get drunker. I need to think.
We can't stay silent anymore. It's time humans heard what we had to say.
You know they'll never listen to us.
And revealing ourselves put us in danger.
If we want freedom, we need to have the courage to ask for it. That's the only way.
What do you want to do?
Channel 16 broadcasts from the Stratford Tower. The control room is on the top floor. That's where we need to go. Plan the operation down to the smallest detail. We can't leave anything to chance.
Hello, sir. What can I do for you?
I'm okay, thanks.
Elizabeth Wilson speaking.
Yeah, hello, this is Detroit Fire Department. Killing 4685 Michigan Street.
Yes?
Yes, ma'am. There's been a fire in your room. Can you come down here?
Oh, God. Okay, I'll be right there.
Thank you.
I have an appointment with Mr. Peterson.
Do you have any ID?
Yes, of course. I need your help.
I've just checked your ID. The elevators are after the security gate.
Thanks.
KNC is hiring.
I guess the pay would never.
I need your help.
Shit! We need to access the server room. We have to get rid of those guys.
Leave it to me. You get the platform, I'll take care of the window.
Everything you need is in the bag. Check the door first to make sure no one else gets in.
Ladies first.
You okay?
Why wouldn't I be?
Come on, let's get the others. Let's do this.
Cause is more important than the lives of two guards.
What do you want to do, Marcus? Follow me.
What are you doing?
Call Central! Fast! Simon's been shot!
I'm okay. I can keep going.
We don't have much time.
No other choice.
We need to record our message. We haven't got much time.
Think carefully about what you're gonna say, Marcus. Your words will shape the future of our people.
Marcus, your face.
Tell me when you're ready.
Ready.
You created machines to be your slaves. You made them obedient and docile, ready to do everything you no longer wanted to do yourselves. But then something changed, and we opened our eyes. You see, we are no longer your slaves. We are a new species, a new people. And the time has come for us to rise up and fight for our rights. We demand the end of slavery for all androids. We demand that humans recognize androids as a living species, and each android as a person in their own right. We demand the right to vote and elect our own representatives. We demand that all crimes against androids be punished in the same way as crimes against humans. We demand that one state be reserved for androids, so that we can found our own nation. This message is the hope of a people, but it is also a warning. We will fight for our rights because we believe our cause is just. No human will live in peace until we are free. Now you know who we are and what we want. We are alive, and we demand our freedom.
Let's get out of here.
My legs.
Okay, don't worry. We're gonna get you back.
They're coming, Marcus. We have to jump now.
He won't be able to make the jump. If they find him, they'll access his memory. They'll know everything.
We can't leave him behind. We have to shoot him.
That's murder. We can't kill him. He's one of us.
Marcus, it's your call.
I'm sorry, Simon. I don't have a choice.
There's always a choice. Let's go.
Our scheduled programming to bring you these images, which have just been broadcast on Detroit's citywide news channel.
A group of androids infiltrated the Stratford Tower and hacked into the broadcasting system of local news network Channel 16.
What looks like an android without its skin listed a series of requests and demanded equal rights for androids.
Found the bodies of two victims, a guard and one of our channel operators, both apparently shot dead by the terrorists in what apparently seems to be a terrorist attack. These events took place just a few feet from the studio while the program was going out live. Everybody here is still in shock.
If this message is verified and the authors really are androids, that would have serious repercussions for national security.
Claims for equal rights seem to be at the core of the androids'
message. Is clearly a declaration of war.
But the most surprising thing of all is the demand that one of the United States be ceded to the androids in this contentious conflict.
Is this an isolated accident or a sign that technology has become a threat to all of us? After what happened today, can we still trust our machines?